I'm sick. I need help.
I'll get you some help, all right?
I'm sick. I need water.
Just lay down. Don't move, man.
Water.
I'll get you water. Just stay right. Don't come near me, okay? Don't make me fucking shoot you, man. Just stay the fuck back, please.
Hey guys, what is up? Niyat here with Film Comics Explained, and today we'll be taking a look at the flesh-eating virus that was featured in the 2002 horror film Cabin Fever, which was written, produced, and directed by Eli Roth. FEV was essentially a physically transmittable, blood-borne, waterborne, and potentially airborne virus that could slowly eat away at a victim's skin. Once transmitted, a host would begin to feel both nauseous and drowsy within an hour as their immune system begins to break down. The skin would then begin to develop rashes and patches that were both red and very tender to touch. Within a few hours, the affected parts of the skin would begin to peel, exposing the underlying dead flesh underneath as the virus permeates throughout the body. As this continues, the wounds would evidently get worse and the host would begin to experience massive amounts of blood loss as a result of this. Once the infection had reached this stage, we noticed that the bond between the surrounding flesh and bone becomes very weak, and that large pieces of flesh would begin to peel away as a response to the slightest amount of pressure. Other parts of the body will soon begin to break out in rashes and patches as the body's organs begin to shut down, leading to major internal hemorrhaging. Within 24 hours of exposure to the virus, the hosts are rendered immobile due to extreme tissue degradation and massive blood loss. In the film, it's not explained what the origins of the virus was, but it is noted by a few characters that lived in the town that there had been a sickness affecting their livestock for some time. In the beginning, we see a hermit living in the woods who gets the virus from his dog. He then stumbles upon a small group of teenagers who had decided to take a small vacation in a nearby cabin and begs them for help. The group is about to let him in when Bert, the more impulsive member of the group, closes the door in his face and stresses the importance of quarantine. The man then enters their truck and begins to vomit blood all over the interior while they try and scare him away. They accidentally end up setting him alight, which sends him running through the woods. Little do they know that he'd essentially collapsed into the nearby reservoir, infecting the cabin's drinking water in return. One by one, the group all begin to contract the awful virus, except for Jeff, who had decided to quarantine himself from his friends. Not only are the infected teens dealing with a terrifying flesh-eating virus, but as the name of the title would suggest, they are also developing claustrophobic reactions to being confined to the cabin. Jeff finally returns to find that his friends were all dead and that the cabin was covered in their blood, before getting shot by local law enforcement, who then begin to burn all the bodies, deciding to adopt the same tactics they would use when dealing with infected livestock. Unfortunately for the town, and ultimately the rest of the country, one of the bodies had been left in a creek that led to where the town received all of their water, and subsequently where they also exported spring water, indicating that the virus was about to spread to other parts of the country. The director, Eli Roth, supposedly got the idea for the film when he himself had contracted a rare skin disease while working on a farm in Iceland when he was 19 years old. After tending to some horse stables, he'd woken up that night with an itchy face, thinking he had mosquito bites, only to look at his hand and find chunks of his own skin. I also think that FEV was loosely modeled on necrotizing fasciitis, which is a real-life infection that results in the death of the body's soft tissue, and is also plain nasty. I really like this film, an ambitious effort by Roth, who had been working on it for almost 8 years. I truly feel as though it's an intelligent horror comedy, disguised as a teen horror flick. Made with a small budget of just over $1 million, the film is a commercial success, pulling in over $30 million at the box office. Well, that's all for today, folks. Thanks to all of you guys who suggested I look at the flesh-eating virus featured in Cabin Fever. If there's any other content you'd like me to check out, please do not hesitate to ask. As always, it's been a pleasure. Niyat here with Film Comics Explained. Thanks for stopping by.
Jesus Christ.
I need a doctor.
No. There's no way this fucking contagious fucker's coming in.
This guy's fucking with us.
Grab your gun.
Fuck.
Come on, hurry up! This is the car! Get out of there! Get out of the car, man!
I'm not fucking